I'm Tom Hoffman with 1-to-1 Media, coming to you from Outside In, Forrester Research Forum for Customer Experience Professionals here in Los Angeles. And I'm joined today by Rob Willms, President and CEO of Optaros. Today, Rob and I will be talking about different ways that retailers can try to strike a balance between working with between different channels. Rob, thanks so much for taking the time out of this.
Great, my pleasure.
So, Rob, we were talking a little bit earlier about some of the challenges that retailers are facing in trying to strike that kind of balance. And, I was wondering if you could shed some light on what you're seeing in the market.
I think we've seen a pretty fundamental shift in how corporations are thinking about serving the needs of consumers. And it's really based on the fact that consumers are gaining a lot more control in the digital channels. That their expectations are now being set by some terrific online retailers like Amazon and Zappos and Apple. And really, corporations are having to respond in how they compete with those kinds of players by thinking about customer experience that leverages all of their assets and all of their local touch points.
Right. Yeah, that is a massive challenge for them. So, what do you suggest are some ways that technology might be used to help provide support for providing that kind of balance that's so desperate to solve?
I think what's really important, if you think about this balance of art and science in technology and customer experience, is to really first understand what your brand and what your business model means to the consumer, and not sort of be following the crowd on things that are specifically driven by technology. If you start off with a customer experience strategy and then use the technology ecosystem to support that, we think that's a much stronger business model for most corporations. And if you really understand the consumer behavior and understand that they don't view you in silos, they don't view your stores different than your website, they want to be recognized, they want to be served in a consistent way, they want to be remembered, and that's a pretty big challenge for a lot of traditional bricks and mortar corporations who have leveraged the power of the internet and e-commerce. And following that kind of trail, you have to think about how do you get a 360-degree view of the customer, and what's a channel-relevant experience that's an extension of your brand.
Good point. So, as part of that, how might analytics be applied to understanding customer behaviors and customer preferences?
Yeah, so I think it is partly what I mentioned is an ability to gain a 360-degree view of the customer. So you have one analytics repository that all channel touch points feed into, and then you have to use that in a way that doesn't scare the customer away.
Sure.
And so it's how can you turn sort of that insight you get from analytics into a service offering for the customer rather than an intrusion, rather than that big brother is watching.
There's also many retailers and other companies as well are challenged by the fact that if we're talking about retail, for example, but they have an online business, they have a physical store presence, they have multiple channels, they often have multiple owners, individual owners for each of those channels, and there are silos that separate them. And I'm wondering, again, how technology could potentially be used to help bring those together, and also some of the cultural things that need to take place so that there's better coordination between those groups.
Well, I think best-in-class corporations are really getting out of the silos. They're starting to think from the lens of the consumer back in. The title of this conference that we're at is Outside In, and that's part of what that philosophy is. It's really looking at your business from the eyes of your consumer, and then aligning both technology and strategy and sometimes organizational design around those outside-in view that's going to fundamentally change the way you think about it. It also just gives you this opportunity for a greater degree of coordination. We've worked in the past with some very large corporations who have so many divisions and so many product groups and so many people that are responsible for components of their business, whether it's physical store, or in many cases, there's a mobile silo, there's an e-commerce silo, there's a marketing and advertising silo, and they're all communicating to the customer from the inside out as opposed to some coordinated manner.
Can you also point to examples of a company or two that you feel have already embraced this and have kind of struck that balance that we were talking about?
So I think like one example I would give that's been very much in the public exposure in what they're doing is Macy's. And it's really, I think, a fantastic story. They are a very large traditional retailer, and I think of them as sort of my grandmother's store. But they've actually done an incredible job of engaging with a newer audience. But they've done something that they've begun to refer to as omnichannel. I'm not sure I love that word. But they've really looked at their mid-office and back-office technologies, and they're trying to build a solution that is much more consumer-friendly. They want a single data repository for analytics. They want a single inventory system and a single pricing system, even if they may be able to change price, so that they can coordinate. That sort of transition of what they call consumerizing their IT is a multi-hundred million dollar, multi-year investment that they need to make, but it is already driving business results for them. The end result will be a channel coordination where they'll have a store experience and a sales person experience on the floor, tablet enabled. They'll be able to defend themselves against things like show moving a little bit better. Huge opportunity for them. It's not easy, and they've made a very strong commitment to it, and I think it will help them continue to see their online and their total revenue.
Great. It's a great example because in this case, it also reflects a company that has such a legacy in retail that it demonstrates that there are opportunities for even a company with that kind of background to make these kinds of changes.
We also see Nordstrom's as another example of they've gotten their organization out of silos, and they really have tried to take the lens of the consumer, and they've reorganized a lot of what they've done, and they now deliver a very seamless cross-channel experience to their customers, and I think they're starting to see what that means.
Well, Rob, thanks so much for your time today. Really appreciate it.
Thanks very much.